Now, Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu's vow for a swift response to the synagogue attack starts shaping up as Israel moves ahead with measures to revoke certain rights of terrorist families. The Prime Minister had a cabinet meeting over the prospects of nullifying the national ID number of the family members who supported the attack. Now, Netanyahu's government further plans to extend the firearms permit by allowing thousands of civilians to carry their own licensed weapons.
בשם כל אזרחי ישראל אני מבקש לשלוח תנחומים מעומק הלב למשפחות הנרצחים בפיגוע הנתעב והנורא בירושלים בירתנו. בפיגוע נפשע בפתח בית כנסת ביום השואה הבינלאומי.
Jerusalem witnessed its deadliest terror attack in over a decade, which left 7 people dead outside a synagogue. According to reports, a 21-year-old opened fire on people who had gathered to pray. The following day, a 13-year-old boy shot and wounded 2 people before being shot and disabled. The 7 victims of the synagogue massacre have been identified and named. The dead include a 14-year-old boy who was laid to rest by the mourners. According to Ukraine's President Volodymyr Zelensky, a Ukrainian woman who was working as a caretaker was also among the deceased. No terror group has claimed responsibility for the same. Now, according to reports, following a brief car chase, the 21-year-old assailant was later shot dead by the police. The synagogue killings took place just a day after an Israeli raid in the West Bank city of Jenin that killed 9 Palestinians. The gunman was allegedly a relative of a 17-year-old Palestinian who was shot dead in clashes with Israeli forces in a Jerusalem refugee camp. The killer arrived at night and opened fire with a handgun, hitting a number of people before he was killed by police. According to reports, 42 suspects, including his family members, have been arrested. Israel's Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu has urged people to not take the law into their own hands. He further added that the cabinet has decided to pursue sanctions against families of attackers. The shooting coincided with the International Holocaust Remembrance Day, has drawn wide condemnation, including by Washington, the United Nations, and Israel's Arab and Western allies.
התגובה שלנו תהיה חזקה, מהירה ומדויקת. מי שינסה לפגוע בנו, אנחנו נפגע בו ובכל מי שמסייע לו. כבר ביצענו מעצרים נרחבים של תומכי טרור, סיינים ומסיתים. אנחנו פורסים כוחות, אנחנו מתגברים כוחות, ואנחנו עושים זאת בזירות השונות. נאטום ונהרוס בתי מחבלים בהליך מזורז כדי לגבות מחיר נוסף מאלה שתמכו בטרור. התהליך הזה כבר החל אתמול והוא נמצא בעיצומו. אני אביא הערב בפני הקבינט צעדים נוספים למאבק בטרור. זה כולל זירוז והרחבה באופן משמעותי של רישוי נשק לאזרחים מורשים. כפי שראינו פעם אחר פעם, כולל הבוקר, הדבר הזה מציל חיים. כמו כן אביא בפני הקבינט שלילת זכויות בביטוח הלאומי ממשפחות תומכי טרור. הממשלה תפעל בתקיפות, בנחישות ובעוצמה נגד הטרור. יהיו גם כמובן אמצעים נוספים שנדווח בסוף הקבינט.
Saudi Arabia, which has no formal ties with Israel, condemned the targeting of civilians and said that an escalation in violence must be halted, while China has called for calm and restraint for both Palestine and Israel. In a statement published by an official Palestinian news agency, Palestinian President Mahmoud Abbas has made no mention of the attack and blamed Israel for the escalation in violence. Abbas's Palestinian Authority, which has limited governing powers in the West Bank, suspended security cooperation arrangements with Israel after the Jenin raid. We are now available in your country. Download the app now. Get all the news on the move.